Hello and welcome to our channel. Today I will show you how to design a small borer band. I start with auxiliary commands. I insert the horizontal vertical line at the upper edge. Next I mirror this line down. And now I proceed with the drop in the center. I use the drop command, snap to the center line, snap here, and here I snap to the intersection. Now I got already my drop. I continue with this triangle. I start with the parallel line here. The distance is about 8 millimeter, so I use parallel command, define 8 millimeter from 2 point. Because I only want to create the parallel line of a section from here to here and to this side. Now I draw lines, the caps of the triangle, and join two of them. This part I can mirror to the left side and now join the whole thing to one closed area. Next I design the dividers in the middle. I use always snap functions to create an accurate design. Then the center dots for the borer. And one part has to be mirrored to the left side. And the whole triangle I can mirror down. I continue with the 6 connected holes above the drop. I have to design the center line first in a parallel distance of 4 millimeter. So I use the parallel command, 4 millimeter. Select the drop and define the section. Now I can already call up the Steffel command. Define a distance of, let me see, 4.5 millimeter and activate round Steffel. Now I just select the center line and I get my 6 connected holes. I continue with this small blood stitch. Also here I use the parallel command. Define a distance of 0.8 millimeter. And also on this side. Lengthen the first line. And actually that's what I need to design a blood stitch. I launch the blood stitch command, select the boundaries and the the first and the last direction line. This blood stitch can immediately be mirrored to the left side. Now I finish the drop line, snap to the center, snap to the boundary. Border center point. And mirror this part to the left side. Okay, now I just copy the repeat and I get already the center of the band. Next, I design the upper Steffel. Also, here I need the center line first. Then I already can call up the Steffel command, define a Steffel distance of 3.5 mm. This time it's not a round Steffel, it's a rectangular one. Select the center line and my Steffel is ready. We have the same Steffel below. To avoid that I have to punch this Steffel two times, I copy the Steffel as a block. So I use the copy command, select the Steffel, define insert copy as block, specify the base point, name, and I insert the Steffel at the right position. Now only the edge is missing. Just design the center line. Call up the edge command. And mirror the edge down. Finally, I copy the repeat. The outlines are ready and I add stitches to the border sections. I start with the Steffel. Find the parameters, and just click on the edge command and the system adds automatically all the stitches. The Steffel here is part of the group, so I have to add the newly designed stitches to the group. And as you can see, the lower Steffel is also updated already. I continue with the round Steffel. To define all the parameters and just click on the object to add the stitches. Now only the triangles and the drop are missing. Call up the command again. This time I use connected holes. Set up the parameters again. Select the boundary and then the order in which the holes have to be designed. Continue is the second one. And now only the drop is missing. And all the stitches are already done. I copy the repeat and our design is actually ready. Now I want to see how our design looks like. I launch ProView and send the design over there. And we see already the border band. I define a fabric, for example this magenta background, and I define the color of the thread, also magenta. And I get already a pretty nice simulation. Finally, I actually want to cut off this fabric here. To do so, I just have to define the area with two rectangles. And define them as mask. Now I refresh the design and we get already the simulation with the fabric cut off. Change also the background color a little bit. And save my simulation. Finally, I want to know how many stitches I am supposed to use, but to get an accurate stitch count, I will add also some underlay. I use the underlay command and I just click on the object and the system will automatically add all underlay. Switch off the sketch to get the clear view of the image. Then I launch the information command, number of stitches, border must be on, and I select all, and I get the result, an estimation of 1,600 turns. What are about 800 stitches. Okay, that's the end of the first part. Thank you for watching. In the second part, I will show you how to punch this design.